और इस वक्त सीधे आपको लेकर चलते हैं, वित्त सचिव प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं, क्या कह रहे हैं वो आपको सुनवाते हैं।
प्लेस प्रॉपरली टू एंश्योर दैट द फार्मर्स गेट स्मूथ सप्लाई ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल इनपुट्स लाइक फर्टिलाइजर्स एंड अदर आइटम्स। द गवर्नमेंट हैज डिसाइडेड दैट एज यू नो क्रॉप लोन्स आर सैंक्शनड बाय द वेरियस बैंक्स सब्जेक्ट टू सर्टेन लिमिट्स। Now it has been decided therefore by the government to permit the farmers to draw up to ₹25,000 per week against the crop loans sanctioned and credited to their accounts subject to the limits, because the farmers, depending on their holding and which crop they are raising, they get various there are limits up to which these loans are sanctioned, and this will also apply to the Kisan credit cards. So up to 25,000 rupees per week the farmers can draw in cash, and these accounts have to be in the name of the concerned farmer. The accounts will have to be naturally KYC compliant, and as I said earlier, this will be subject to the loan limits. The second decision which has been taken by the government is that, as you know, the farmers go to the APMC markets or the the agricultural mandis which we have in various parts of the country, and the agricultural producers marketing committees run these mandis. So farmers who sell their produce, agricultural produce of the last season, the kharif season, who sell their produce in the mandis, and these produces are, as you know, purchased by the traders. So the government has decided that the payments which the farmers receive, either by way of check which is deposited into the account, bank account of the farmer, or which is credited to the by RTGS method into the bank account of the farmer, from that account the farmers can draw up to ₹25,000 per week. It has to be naturally from the farmer's own account, and let me also add that these accounts have to be KYC compliant. This is the second decision which the government has taken. So this will enable the farmers to have cash in their hands and to carry on with their normal agricultural activities in terms of purchasing inputs or in terms of purchasing seeds and their other requirements. The third decision that has been taken by the government is that, as you know, we have these APMC markets, mandis, as I mentioned. So the traders who are registered with the APMC markets, they will be permitted to draw ₹50,000 per week. And like business entities, we have already, the government has permitted that business entities also are permitted to draw ₹50,000 per week. So similarly, the registered traders with the APMC markets also will be permitted to draw ₹50,000 per week, because they have various sundry cash requirements of payment of wages on a daily basis to the workers and other sundry expenses. So this will facilitate smooth procurement process in the mandis and will help the farmers to sell their produce without any difficulty. And these accounts of the traders, registered traders, naturally will have to be KYC compliant accounts. I would like to mention that all the cases where government is very particular that these accounts will have to be KYC compliant. The fourth decision is that relates to the crop insurance premium, the payment of crop insurance premium. Now the time limit, there is a certain time limit up to which the crop insurance can be paid. And the states fix various time limits for, depending on their local agricultural and farming conditions. So it has been decided, therefore, by Government of India that the time limit in all such cases of crop loan, that is payment of crop loan insurance premium, the time limit will be extended by 15 days. This will help the farmers to sort of pay their crop insurance premium and avail the benefit of the crop insurance. The fifth point relates to the wedding ceremonies which are being conducted now. This is the wedding season, and representations have been received by the government, and the Honorable Prime Minister, the Honorable Finance Minister also have got a number of representations from various sections. So this has been considered by the government, and it has been decided that for marriage, for wedding ceremonies which are going on, up to 2.5 lakh rupees will be permitted to be drawn from the bank account. Now, naturally, again, these accounts will have to be KYC compliant accounts. And there has to be drawn one per marriage, and it can be drawn either from the account of the father or the mother, or the account of either of the, you know, the boy or the, I mean, those who are getting married. And let me complete, please. And these accounts naturally will have to be subject to KYC. There has to be PAN details mentioned against the card, and a self-declaration also will be obtained that the money is being drawn only from one account, because it is possible that in a family there will be multiple accounts by the parents or by the son or by the daughter. So therefore, there will be a self-declaration, and it is our expectation that the people will adhere to this norm. People in our country are generally law-abiding, and our expectation, government's expectation, is that people will abide by this rule, by this condition. And but nonetheless, just to enforce and to implement it effectively, a self-declaration will be obtained. The sixth point which has been decided by the government is that, as you know, over-the-counter exchange of notes. Now, let me make it very clear. I am only talking of over-the-counter exchange of old 500 and 1000 rupee notes in return for the new cash. I am not referring to withdrawal from bank accounts. I repeat, I am not referring to withdrawal from bank accounts. I am only referring to exchange of notes, that is old 500 and 1000 rupee notes, to get the new notes. In those cases, we are to enable larger number of people to get the benefit of exchanging their notes, to enable larger number of people to get this benefit, it has been decided that with effect from tomorrow, that is 18th of November, the existing limit of 4500 rupees will be reduced to rupees 2000, and this will be permitted only once per person, once against one account, or once per person. So therefore, the indelible ink has been introduced, and this we hope will ensure that larger number of people are enabled to reach the counter to exchange their notes. And number seven, with regard to the central government employees up to Group C, including the equivalent levels in defense, in paramilitary forces, railways, and central public sector enterprises, up to Group C, they will be given an option to draw salary advance up to rupees 10,000 in cash. And this salary advance will be adjusted against their November salary. And it is expected that this will relieve the pressure on the banks, the queues, the long queues, and the pressure which we have on the banks. So these are the operational guidelines, the decisions taken by the government relating to the operational aspects of the functioning of the banks and the segment of banks which affect the farmers and also other segments of society. So I would like to stop here. Thank you very much.
एक सबसे बड़ा सवाल यह है कि इस समय सबसे बड़ी उलझन है कि तमाम जगहों से खबरें आ रही हैं प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल को लेकर के, कोई अभी तक सरकार ने आदेश नहीं दिया। खबरें ये भी आ रही हैं कि उसे एग्जम्प्ट किया जाना चाहिए था, लेकिन अभी तक ऐसा कुछ हुआ नहीं। क्या सरकार इस पर कोई बड़ा फैसला ले सकती है आने वाले समय में, क्योंकि प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल में बड़ी दिक्कत है इस समय?
नहीं, किसी भी चीज में जब सरकार में कोई फैसला होता है तो हम उसको अनाउंस करते हैं। क्या कंसिडरेशन में है, क्या कंसिडरेशन में नहीं है, ये कहना मतलब ठीक नहीं है। जब डिसीशन किसी मामले में होता है, हम तुरंत उसका अनाउंस कर देते हैं।
सर, रिड्यूसिंग द लिमिट फ्रॉम 4500 टू 2000, डज इट रिफ्लेक्ट दैट देयर इज नॉट इनफ करेंसी अवेलेबल विद द गवर्नमेंट?
दैट इज टोटली रॉन्ग, दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट एट ऑल। देयर इज इनफ कैश अवेलेबल विद द गवर्नमेंट, एज आई हैव स्टेटेड ऑन अर्लियर ओकेजन ऑल्सो। दिस इज मेनली टू एनेबल larger number of people to reach the counter. We find that many people are not able to reach the counter because the same persons, as I said earlier, same persons are visiting the counters multiple times. So therefore, other people are not getting the benefit.
Sir, on the wedding day,
you mentioned that only a single exchange will be allowed. Is there this single exchange of cash will be a single time thing, or is it single exchange per unit time, for example, per week or per
no, no. Days? It's only once.
So in the marriage thing, does it apply to the entire wedding, or it is to 2.5 lakh rupees to the girl side, 2.5 lakh rupees to the
boy? The operational guidelines, we will be issuing a detailed press note which will clarify all these aspects.
ATM cash bank bank
कैश जो है उसका हर तरीके से ट्रांसपोर्टेशन हो रही है. रिजर्व बैंक और बैंक्स और जो बाकी जिस जो जो लोग इसमें इन्वॉल्व है उन्होंने कंटिजेंसी प्लान तैयार किया हुआ है, और जहां जहां डेली मतलब कैश का कोई शॉर्टेज का रिपोर्ट आता है तो तुरंत वहां पे कैश हम लोग पहुंचा रहे हैं. और एटीएम्स की जो बात कह रहे हैं उसके लिए एक टास्क फोर्स बनाई गई थी रिजर्व बैंक डिप्टी गवर्नर के अध्यक्षता में. वो टास्क फोर्स की मीटिंग हो गई है, डिटेल डिलीबरेशन कंप्लीट हो गई है, और उन्होंने एक रोड मैप ड्रॉप किया हुआ है जिसके हिसाब से हमारा उम्मीद ये है कि अगले कुछ ही दिनों में मैक्सिमम एरिया मतलब प्रोग्रेसिवली ये जो है वो एटीएम काउंटर वगैरह वो अपग्रेड मतलब वो रिकैलिब्रेशन आप जिसको कहते हैं वो हो जाएगा.
सर, 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 सर,